Auction conditions. When you open an auction you'd like to join, you will notice a drop-down function called More on the auction. Every auction has some specific conditions, so let's look at the ones that apply here. Viewing times. If an auction is taking place on an online platform, it is still strongly recommended that you conduct a physical inspection of all the lots you wish to place bids on. The location of the assets and the pre-agreed viewing dates and times are all supplied. Where this information is not published, don't hesitate to contact the relevant auction manager in order to arrange a site visit. In addition to the physical inspection of the assets you are interested in, you may in some instances be able to refer to an attached condition report. Also refer to our tutorial video in the video library entitled Vehicle Inspection. Commission structure, administration fees and VAT. There are various costs added to the hammer price that impact on your total invoice amount. Buyer's commission is payable in most instances and could vary from auction to auction and from lot to lot. It's important to familiarize yourself with the applicable rate at which buyer's commission will be charged. In some instances, administration fees are also levied, especially where registered and/or licensed vehicles are being auctioned. And then finally, there should be VAT charged, which is usually also excluded from the hammer price. Deposit. As an indication of your commitment to the auction, AUCOR requires a registration deposit and the amount will be indicated here. Upon registration, the banking details for the payment of this deposit will be communicated to you. If you don't purchase anything during the auction, the deposit will be refunded in full. The finance team will contact you for your banking details. Auction invoice calculator. Keeping track of all these costs can seem a bit daunting, but we have a solution for that. Go to the top of your screen and click on returntoaucor.com. Go to the calendar and select the auction you are interested in. Now go to View Auction. And then go to the lot and click on Product Details. At the top you will see Calculator. The auction calculator has been pre-populated with all the relevant costs, allowing you to enter your proposed bid. Upon entering your planned bid amount, click on Calculate, and an amount will appear on the right in red, showing your invoice amount. When you have your calculated amount, return to the top of the page and click on live.aucor.com. Dispatch procedure. This procedure will be the last step in collecting your lot as purchased. Upon conclusion of the auction, if you won the lot you bid on, you will receive a pro forma invoice from the AUCOR auction team via the email address you supplied when you registered for the auction. The banking details for payment of the lot will be included in this email and you will also be confirmed via a text message. When you have settled the invoice and provided the proof of payment to the sender of the invoice, you will receive an invoice along with a release note. You may then take this release note to the location where your lot is held, where the lot will be checked against your paid invoice and released to you. Paperwork and documentation for vehicles bought will also be handed to you. If the paperwork or documentation is not available at the time of collection, arrangements will be made to courier it to you once it becomes available. Site and/or asset-specific dispatching procedures will be available for your perusal on our various online platforms. The spectator functionality. Should you wish to view an online auction without the capability of placing any active bids, you may do so by registering to bid here. And we will send an email to your given email address. In this mail, we will explain what registering for an auction entails. When you reply to our mail, you may instruct us to give you spectator rights. Your approval will be limited to viewing only, with no transactional rights.